Hello and welcome to Light Assault Video Guide series. My name is Iridar and today we're gonna be talking about first hours of a newborn Light Assault. This will be the first video in a series of very thorough gameplay commentary, explaining every decision and every little thing I do. If you're looking just for a quick guide on which stuff to unlock first and what stuff do you need in general, I'm gonna leave a couple of links for you in video description below. But with that out of the way, let's get started. I'm gonna create a new character, but my advice will work just as well for any existing character of yours. First, I'm gonna move to the warp gate of a continent that has action going. Okay, I'm a Light Assault and I'm looking for combat. First, I'm gonna go the lazy way and check where instant action would take me. It picks a roughly 50-50 fight, which is good enough. First thing you wanna do after deployment is to assess the situation. Make sure that I'm immediately safe by looking around, then get into cover and check the big map. Here is what I see. There seems to be no enemies in the base itself, and the capture point is safe. The only enemies on the map are on the south road. But the region population counter still shows at least 48 enemies, so we can assume the majority of enemy forces are somewhere around that road, advancing on the attack plant from the VS base to the south. The northern ridge can potentially be a great area for a light assault combat, and we can expect enemies to be advancing over that ridge. That would actually be a pretty terrible way to attack this base, because even if they take the ridge, they will still have the spawn room between them and the capture point, but such lack of strategy is common in PlanetSide 2. First I'm gonna scout for enemy contacts to get a better grasp on the situation. There seem to be a few enemies on the other side of the road, but because of all the combat on the road, I can't get to the other side, and my carbine doesn't have the effective range to engage enemies that far. So I'm gonna have to stay on this side and scout the ridge. I have reason to expect enemy light assaults there, but even if there aren't any, I can use the ridge as a superior position to attack enemies down on the road. By protecting the ridge from enemies, I won't be helping my faction in any way. But I'm not overly concerned with that currently. For now, I just want to pick up some kills to get better gear and have fun. It's not like enemies going through the ridge would be doing anything good for their faction either. When using the jetpack to climb the rocks, try to stay as close to terrain as possible. This will reduce your exposure, and if you encounter an enemy, you will be able to land very quickly, as you can't really return fire while flying. Case in point. But I need more. I see movement. That light assault wasn't aware of me and I had time to get closer to get a better aim on him. I fired a bit too soon, but it didn't matter. Always keep one eye on the minimap, and it shows another enemy to me. The enhanced targeting implant told me that he barely has any health, so I just fire a wide burst vaguely in his direction as I need only one hit to finish him. Notice the large delay between me firing and actually getting the kill. This is because I'm playing on a US server from Europe. I have my own reasons for this, but I don't actually recommend anyone to play outside your region, as that delay will hinder you a lot. I see another unaware enemy. My recoil control is a bit rusty. To compensate for Track 5's recoil, pull the mouse down and to the left. That light assault made a mistake. He was engaged first, and by the time he started returning fire, he already was severely wounded. A smarter decision would be to run away to reset the engagement, and being almost in cover, he had the opportunity for it. Another enemy that doesn't look around. I don't know why he was looking into wall, what he wanted to see there, his death maybe. Returning to patrol. By now I've killed a few enemies here, and I can expect for them to actively start looking for me. So I need to stay on the move. That guy obviously was wounded, otherwise he wouldn't die so fast. Those guys are clearly too far for my carbine, but maybe a lucky frag grenade will do something. Not this time. The minimap warns me about an enemy. Track 5 has a large magazine, and with good enough aim can get 2 kills before having to reload. At this range I would prefer to hip fire, so I can move faster and keep myself safer. But I have a limited amount of ammo to kill the second enemy, and I can't afford any misses, so I have to keep aiming down sights. Back to patrol. For a second there I was thinking about going to enemy side of the ridge to engage enemies on the road, but the second ridge on the other side of the road probably has snipers on it and I decided it's too risky and keep patrolling my side of the ridge. Another enemy detected. Even though that was a bit too far, with proper recoil control and bursting, Track 5 can actually reach quite far, and large magazine ensures at least one kill. Also, I engage the enemy from cover and I keep moving while firing, while the enemy is completely exposed out in the open. When engaging as light assault, you want to stack as many advantages as possible, such as element of surprise, positional advantage, and being within your weapon's effective range. I talk more about this in my light assault basic strategy video. Back to patrol. Enemy spotted, likely a medic, I wound him, but not enough to kill. And I also see another enemy. Now that I have flashed my position to the enemy, I'm not going to keep engaging from the same spot. I'll move around and flank. I didn't hear them spot me, so this should increase the element of surprise. I see an unaware enemy and execute him quickly. I see another enemy and his shield's flashing, which means they just started regenerating. So he barely has over half HP at most. This must be the first player I wounded. This is a bit too far for hip firing, but because he's not at full health, I can afford it. And I need it, because he's about to shoot me and I must evade. At this moment in time, I do not see the third VS soldier to the right, because it's all too hectic and he blends in with the rock. Only as I kill the second player, I notice the third guy and engage him by inertia. It wasn't a smart decision. I spent all my ammo on hip firing to enemies, and I probably don't have enough to kill a third guy, especially if he turns out to be a heavy assault. I've exhausted all element of surprise and overextended by moving forward so much, and I didn't have any advantages over the enemy. Immediately disengaging wasn't a safe option either, as I was too far from nearest cover, but it still was less risky. I can only thank my good aim and bad enemy reaction for this kill. As soon as fighting is over, I move to a flanking position to possible incoming enemy reinforcements. I see movement and hit spot a few times but don't catch the enemy. Just to be safe, I move a bit. Moving closer, I engage from high ground while strafing. Unfortunately, the enemy manages to wound me and an enemy tank notices me and starts firing. I maneuver on the jetpack the best I can, but splash damage catches up with me. In this case, the grid killed me. I could just spot that enemy and flank him as he moves up the ridge, where I would be safe from enemy tank fire. It is time to put the blood earned certification points to good use. Now, in my opinion, Light Assault has only one good loadout slash template, and you can read about it in my Light Assault guide, which I have linked in the description. Eventually, I will want to upgrade to that loadout, but for now I focus on essentials, just to get my gear into playable state. Jump jets to rank 4, scope for the gun, I'm gonna use 1x reflex, which is what I use on most of automatic weapons. Reasoning is provided in the video description. Medkits to rank 1 and spend leftovers on nanoweave. Let's get back into action. On my way back, I hear an ally spot and shoot an enemy engineer, and I see him on the minimap, so I move to engage. Target lost. Hearing gunfire behind me, I realize the enemy went opposite direction. I move to high ground to give chase, but enemy changes directions once again, but doesn't notice me, so I kill him in the back. This ridge really looks like crap, so I'm checking my settings to make sure I have terrain quality on high. Moving up, I suddenly see an enemy. I'm not sure where is he looking, so I don't risk and engage him right away. There was a potential chance of him getting away, but didn't happen this time. Returning back to patrol. I hear an allied sniper and I move to check if he needs any help, but an enemy tank persuades me to leave. Seems there is no more enemies on the ridge, so I widen my search pattern. I see some enemies over by that wall, so I'm moving around the gunfire to get closer to them. But on my way, I notice a stalker infiltrator with a bugged cloak. His head doesn't enter the deep cloak state with his body. I feel sorry for the guy, so I explain to him why I was able to see him. I continue on my way to that wall, but I notice some enemies on the minimap inside the base, so I decide to deal with them first. I keep strafing to evade enemy fire, but he still manages to double click me with Underboss, which kills with one headshot and one body shot at this range. Good shooting. Before spawning again, I check the map and I see that now we have massive overpop and there is nothing to do for me on this base. And this is the end of this episode. In the next episode we're gonna continue right from this moment. I hope you enjoyed the video, feel free to like, share, subscribe, etc. Leave your feedback and I will take it into account in the following episode. Thank you for watching, I'll see you next time.